Hi everyone, welcome back to our channel. Hope you guys are well. So today in this tutorial I am going to show you how you guys can make this amazing landing page using just HTML and CSS. And first let's see what we have in our website. Here you can see that in the left top we have a discovery channel logo, and here in the right we have our navigation bar. And if we hover on our navigation bar, here you can see that we have created an amazing hover effect. So you guys can see that this hover effect is looking so cool. And yeah, and now in the middle we have our title and some dummy text, and here is our main button which is load more. So if we hover on this button, you can see that this is also looking good. So yeah, that's it for now. I will show you how you guys can make this using just HTML and CSS. And before we start, if you guys are new in my channel, then please subscribe my channel, like this video and press the bell icon for the future videos. And if you guys have any question about this video or any other video, you guys can comment below and let me know some of your opinion about our channel. So yeah, let's go to our text editor. So here in our HTML, you have to just create a basic HTML structure and just give a title and link your style sheet. So now first in our website, here you can see that we have our logo and our navigation bar. So I will first create our logo and our navigation bar. So that's why create a div tag, and the class name of this div tag will be container. That's it. And inside this container tag I will create another div tag for our logo. So that's why class name will be also logo. And our logo is image, so that's why create an image tag. And inside this source section we have to put our image file name. So our image file name is logo.png. That's it. So after logo I will create our navigation bar, so that's why create another div tag, and the class name will be nav. That's it. And inside this nav class I will create another list. Okay, so and inside this another list I will create list tag. And inside this list tag I will create anchor tag for our nav link. So here will be hash, and our first nav link will be home. So I will just copy this line and paste it here 3 times. And here you can see that our second one is about gallery and contact. So this will be about, and this will be gallery, and this will be contact. That's it. If we now save and go our website and refresh, so here you can see that we can see our logo, and here is our navigation links. So now I have to style this. So first we have to give a background image, so that's why go to our style sheet, and here first you have to create some basic setting, and after here we have to now write body tag. That's it. And here I will create our background image, so that's why background image. And here in this URL we have to put our background image name, which is back.jpg. That's it. If we now save and go our website and refresh, so here you can see that this is our background image, but it is not in a specific height and width. So that's why first we have to give a width and height. So that's why width will be 100% and height will be 100 vh. Okay, so and for background position it will be center, and background size will be cover. That's it. If we now save and go our website and refresh, okay, so now we have to give a specific width and height to our logo. So that's why I will go to our HTML file, and here just click container and copy this container class and paste it here. And here you can see that in this container class we have our two section. First one is logo and second one is our nav. And now I want these two things in one row, so that's why I will give display will be flex, and flex direction will be row, because I want in one row. And justify content will be a space between, because I want a space from between, that's why a space between. And align items will be center. That's it. If we now save our website and go and refresh, so here you can see that this is our logo and here is our nav links. there is our navlinks in one row. Now I have to give a specific width and height to our logo. So that's why I copy this container class from here, paste it here. Now we have to grab our logo class from the HTML here, logo, copy this logo and paste it here. Now here I will give a width of 13%, that's it, and copy this container and logo class again and paste it here. Now this time I will grab our image tag, so that's why in image it will take 100%. Now if we go and refresh, so here you can see that this is now in our logo in a specific width and height, and our background is also in position. So here you can see that in the left side we have our logo and in the right side we have our nav links. So now I want to style these nav links, and I want these nav links in one row. Now it is in one column and I want this in one row. So that's why again copy this container and paste it here, and grab this nav class from here and again paste it here. And now I will grab our another list, so that's why UL, that's it. And now I want in one row, so that's why display would be flex, and flex direction will be in one row, and align items will be center. That's it. If we now go and refresh, so here you can see that now these nav links in one row, but we don't have a space between these nav links, so I want some space or padding. So that's why I copy this from here and paste it here. Now this time I will grab our list tag from here, so that's why list. So here I will give padding from left side 30 pixel. So if we go now and save and refresh, so here you can see that now we have a space between the nav links. Now here you can see that we can see some bullet points, so I don't want this bullet points, so that's why this style will be none. If we go and refresh, so here you can see that now we don't have any bullet points. Now I have to style our nav links. Here we have underline, I don't want this underline, so that's why copy this list and container nav everything from here and paste it here. Now I will target our anchor tag, and from here first I will remove the underline, so that's why text decoration will be none. Okay, color will be white, and font size will be not a style, font size will be, let's see, 1.2 em, and font width will be 300. That's it. If we now save and go our website and refresh, so here you can see that now we have our navigation links, and this is in white color. Now I want some space from the top and from left and from right also, so that's why go to our container class, and here in the container class I will give padding. From top it will take 50 pixel, and from right it will take 70 pixel, from bottom it will take 0, and from left it will take also 70 pixel. That's it. If we go now save and refresh our website, so here you can see that now we have a space from the top, left and right here. So yeah, so here you can see that in our real website we have a overlay on the background image, so I will now create this overlay. So that's why go to our body tag, and here in the background image I will create linear gradient, so that's why linear gradient. And here I have to give some RGBA value, so that's why RGBA, and the RGBA value will be, for first one it will be 0 0 0, and 0.6. I will give a RGB value of 0.6. copy this thing and paste it here again. So if we now save and go our website and refresh, so here you can see that now we have our background overlay. So yeah, now we have to create this heading and our dummy text and our logo. So that's why go to our HTML again, and here we have to create another div tag, and this time the class name will be box. That's it. And inside this box first I have to create a h2 tag, and here I have to write, and here you can see that in our website reality is actually in another style. We style this word differently, so that's why I will put this reality word in a different span tag. So that's why I have to create a span tag, and here I have to write reality. That's it. And after our h2, now I have to create some paragraph, so that's why I will create a paragraph tag, and here just type lorem and tab, and I don't want this much, so that's why I delete this. That's it. And underneath this paragraph I want a button, so that's why I have to create an anchor tag, and this will be hash, and the name of this button will be load more. That's it. If you now save and go our website and refresh, so here you can see that now we have our heading, our paragraph and our button. Okay, so I want this thing to be in center, so that's why copy this box class and paste it here. That's it. And because I want in center, so that's why display will be flex, and flex direction will be column, because I want in one column. And justify content will be center, align items will be center, and text align will be also center. Now I want to give some width and height, and I will give a width of 60%. Okay, and I will give a height of looks 80 bh. That's it. If we go now save and refresh our website, now here you can see that this paragraph, this heading and this button is actually centered in from the top, and I want to center this thing from the left and right also. So that's why here you can see that we have some actually margin, so that's why I have to create this margin auto. So save and go our website and refresh. So yeah, you can see that now everything is in the center. So first thing I will do is I will style our heading. So that's why copy this box class from here, and our heading was s2, and let's first give a font size will be 6 rem. That's it. And font width will be bold, and I will give the color of white. That's it. If we now go and save and refresh, so here you can see that now we have our white heading. And in our website you can see that this reality word is actually a different style, so I will do this here also. So copy this box again and paste it here, and this time I have to give the span which we created. So I copy this span tag from here and just paste it here. So yeah, and I will give a opacity of 0.5. save and refresh. So now you can see that our reality is now in different style. So now I will style our paragraph also. So that's why copy this whole thing again and paste it here. And instead of s2 I have to write paragraph for a paragraph, and the font size will be 1.4 rem, and the font width will be 300, and the color will be white. And I want a space from the bottom, so that's why padding from bottom will be 30 pixel. That's it. If we go and refresh, and here you can see that we have our paragraph, and we have also some space from the bottom because I gave padding from bottom 30 pixel. So yeah, now I will style our button. So that's why copy this thing again, paragraph, and paste it here. And here instead of paragraph I have to write a because of anchor tag. And so here in our button I will give a font size of 1.3 rem, and the font width will be 300, and the color will be, actually I will change this color to this one. That's it. And I will give a background color, and I want the background color to be white. That's it. And I want some padding from top and bottom, it will be 13 pixel, and from left and right it will be 30 pixel. That's it. If we go and save, refresh our website, so here you can see that actually here we have to, yeah, that's it. If we go now save and refresh, so here you can see that now we have our background, white color background, and we have a different font color. Now I don't want this underline, so that's why text decoration will be none. That's it. And here you can see that in our real website we have a rounded button, so I want this thing to here also. So that's why border radius, I have to create border radius 50 pixel. That's it. Save, refresh. Yeah, So here you can see that now we have our border space. So now I want to decrease the font size a little bit, so that's why it will be 1.2. save, refresh. Yeah, that's it. And now I want a border also, so that's why border will be 1 pixel and it will be solid, and the border color will be white. That's it. Save and refresh. You can't see the border yet. So now I have to create our hover effect like this one. So for doing this, we have to just copy this box and anchor tag, paste it here. Now write hover. That's it. We just have to change the color and the background color. So copy this thing here and paste it here. And I want the color to be white. Our font color will be white and our background color will be transparent. Okay, so now save and refresh. So here you can refresh, and here you can see that we have our button hover, but it is not smooth, so that's why we had to give some transition, all 0.3 seconds. So now save and go our website and refresh. So if we now hover, so you can see that it is looking good. Now we have to create this effect, this hover effect, in our nav links also. So that's why I will go to our nav link and here copy this thing and paste it here. Just write hover. That's it. So now go down and here we just have to copy this from here, color, and here everything from here, and paste it to our hover section. And from here I don't want this text decoration, and in border radius I want not 50, I want 30 pixel, and I don't and here we have to give this border and the transition. I don't want this transition here, it will be in the list here. So if we go now and save and refresh our website, so if we now hover, you can see that, yeah, I will delay this hover effect a little bit more. This will be 5. Save and refresh. Yeah, now it is looking good, and this hover effect is working well. So yeah, I think our website is done. Here we have our logo, our nav links, and our heading, our paragraph, and our button. So that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed our tutorial, and if you guys really enjoyed our tutorial, then please subscribe and press the bell icon for the future videos. And if you guys have any question about this video or any other video, you guys can comment below. So that's it guys. Thank you so much guys for watching this video.